This video shows the follow-up analysis of a non-observable interaction in a mixed ANOVA and SPSS. If an interaction effect can be observed, the video linked in the info cards should help. This video focuses on analyzing the between subjects effect and or within subjects effect with a sufficiently small p-value. For this video, I will pretend that I could not observe an interaction effect in my sample data. In this case, estimated marginal means must be calculated. To do this, click on the EM means button in the mixed ANOVA dialog box. The desired effects are moved to the right in the box display means for, in my example for both group and time, since they have both sufficiently low p-values. Again, under the assumption that I could not observe an interaction effect. The compare main effects box is also ticked. When adjusting the confidence interval, the conservative approach with Bonferroni should be selected. This not only corrects the confidence interval when testing multiple times on the same sample, but also the p-value. At the same time, a line plot is generated using the diagrams button. The within subjects factor, here time, is moved to the horizontal axis. The between subjects factor, here group, is placed in the separate lines field. Click on add so that the diagram appears in the list and tick include error bars and select the 95% confidence interval. All other options can be left as they are. Now let's look at the output. We start with the estimated marginal means section and the analysis for the groups. The descriptive statistics are followed by the pairwise comparisons. As I only have two groups in my example, there is only one comparison. The within subjects effect does not play a role here. Only the between subjects effect is considered. With more groups, there are correspondingly more comparisons shown. A group difference can be observed here because the significance is sufficiently small. This is followed by the within subject effect, which I called time. The pairwise comparisons are shown between all time points, and here we can observe a sufficiently small p-value, and thus a difference, but only between time points 1 and 5. Depending on the data, this may be due to only one or even several groups. However, only an observable interaction enables further differentiation, so that only general conclusions can be drawn without an interaction. A look at the development of the mean values in the line chart can show trends, but nothing more. Again, please note, in my example, I was able to observe an interaction effect, and the tests just shown were only shown for reasons of teaching under the assumption of no interaction effect. After analyzing the within subjects and between subjects effect, I can calculate the respective effect sizes of my results or calculate the effect size for the mixed ANOVA itself.